Catch her up and I'm taking his jewelry. Catch her up and I'm taking his jewelry. I said, don't get it twisted. Just cause I smell a lot, that don't mean I'm with the foolery. When I woke up my school, all the staff fooling me. I'm like, you used to tutor me. I stay in the cut like a band-aid. And that's where my shooters be. One down, gun tuck, tool on me, tool on me. Rush switch, plus one. They do not know what just started. I pop a burger retarded, then mac up the Rory, then fuck up my grandmother's apartment. I'm rocking Louis V. Cause I ain't too pressed with the young. No teller, but I'm the Messiah, the only creator. I got the drip in my pool. I can never kiss a whore. Fuck her life up, then go up a tour. She know we up on the board. I got the 4-5 tucked in my drawer. They like, what's on your ring? 11 carats that come with a bad bitch in a mansion. And she from Paris. Mercy for cool, worship for cool. I don't got nothing to prove, nah. It's either you win or you lose. It's either you win or you lose. And I don't really care what your gang claim. All I know is my niggas is woo. So I said, hold on, boost. Huh, I shoot a nigga out the cool. We.
All black, let's do a hit. Starting off the first full day, I think we're gonna go get, not I think, we are gonna go get coffee. Gonna go to the Museum of Contemporary Art. Have a pie reservation. By pie, I mean pizza, 3 p.m. And then we'll figure out something between 3 and 9, because 9 is our next reservation, so.
Of course, we stay masked up. ASAP hand sanitizer on us at all times. Let's go.
This store looks pretty cool. Might have to come back. Never mind, I spoke too soon. That place looking kind of sorry. Here's my matcha latte. This is the frittata, and then the matcha latte. Matcha lattes taste better when they're sweet. Frittata, arugula, chives. Pastries are fire, so we're gonna get another one or two. They're so good. She's literally taking them out of the oven right now. Okay, added another pastry. This is a potato pastry. It is savory, not sweet. Black and white sesame seeds to finish. Look at how flaky it is. Deadass looks like an accordion. And then I got a Japanese iced coffee. This one's on tap, but I wanted to see how it compares to what I make. Kinda tastes like cold brew though. Oh, look how flaky it is. You can hear it. Dude. Oh, this is really good. Blew that bathroom up, about to go to the MCA. That image store had a fat ass line. I think they're dropping shoes or something. All right, these are what they dropped. You got me fucked up if you think I'm gonna wait in line for these. It's hot out right now, but it's nowhere near as hot as Portland was when we were there. I think it's like 90 right now. It's bearable.
Cute little lock here.
It actually locks all over this thing, so. Everyone's out here playing Pokemon Go. Everyone's got these like Pikachu things on their head. The Keith Haring exhibit is open.
What the heck is the octopus initiative thing? A long story, but basically we like art, we like it a lot, we believe art has the power to inspire, challenge, and enrich our lives, yada yada yada.
So we're on the first floor, downstairs is the Jamie Corral. We're going vibes. Essence vibe. Cute little garden. Was real? No. 100% fake. Sour rosé fermented with blueberries. I feel so guilty. It's only noon. I'm drinking alcohol already. Jack just caught a meal twice. Cheese. So we're going to a vintage shop called La Lovely. It's kind of on our way to our lunch reservation, so it makes a lot of sense. And it looked like the only promising vintage shop here, so we'll see. We'll see what they have.
It's a photo.
No, it's not.
It's a photo.
You're recording.
Black short jacket's really nice.
Oh yeah, I would have tried to like dig them out of the ground. It was just like I could see like hundreds of bunnies.
Red is really faded. 34 by 36. Redline is really faded. I could probably pick this. 320.
These 517s?
These are long though. 517, orange label, $85.
I might pick up like a sweater or something. I like these like dead stock thermals.
Oh, this is from Target.
This little one pocket. It's $26.
Look at it back here.
All right, I'm gonna try on this tee. Let's see if it fits. This thing's way too narrow. You see this? Three pairs of jeans. First pair. Really baggy. The wash is kind of eh. This pair, let's see if it's a winner. This pair is kind of long. And I don't know about the wash. Eh. No, this is maybe a thumbs up. What do you think of this pair? Obviously, I wouldn't wear them with runners, you know? I'd wear them with like boots or something. Pretty clean, not gonna lie. This pair is 110. I swear to God, nothing fits better than helmet jeans. These are both 501XXs. I'm not the biggest fan of this cut. Wait a minute, these are 501XXs also. What the fuck? So yeah, these all fit, but they just don't fit how I want them to. Yeah, this is much better. Give it a turn. Turn. The wash is nice, and this fits much better. I could probably fit that thing too. How much is that?
150.
This is 150?
Yeah.
What is it? What brand is it? Oh, it's 125. What is this though? I can barely read the thing. Something with an S. I don't know. Fits good though. Fits good on you. He wrote down some vintage spots. Alright, he added one more spot. This is Studbrook. And apparently they carry Rick, Bode, Raph, etc. The ambience. Sick vibe. Here's the drink menu. I already had beer.
Can I grab anything to start?
I was gonna do a beer. Is there anything local? We're visiting, we're not.
Yeah, most of our draft are
local.
The only one that isn't is the La Cumbre. La Cumbre is based out of New Mexico.
Okay. How's the Four Noses?
The Four Noses? It's nice. It's a good IPA, nice, super hoppy.
Okay. Yeah, let me try that though.
Can we grab your ID real quick?
Yeah. Thank you. I'm not used to getting carded anymore.
Thank you.
Yeah, I think we're ready to order.
Yeah, 100%.
So let's do a margarita.
Okay.
We can do the chilies and pack. Okay. Is there something you recommend?
Personally, over like the year and a half or so I've worked here, the Hunter has been my consistently favorite food.
Yeah, I was looking at that bison chorizo, caramelized onions. Let's do the Hunter. Okay, I think that's it for right now. I have here the Four Noses Bout Damn Ale IPA. Cheers. Nothing like an IPA on a hot day. Hunter.
I'm gonna grab this big slice. I like margarita. Very, very copper. So good. Margarita is a.
proper piece of za. Come on, mom. Bison chorizo. Bison chorizo. 8.5. 8.5. Shit is like sweet and spicy.
This one is gonna be interesting. Man, they're using really nice dough. Look at that.
There's not with the milk. With their own mills and stuff.
This one's really sweet already.
This one I think has like honey or something on it.
I like those burnt edges to the pepperoni. Yes, sir.
I don't want to hand out 9, it's like it's just casual, you know? But since this is my favorite, 8.75.
There's like, what, like 3-4 different types of cheeses?
It's just a slice of cheese.
Place called Goldmine Vintage. It was recommended by a dude at La Lovely. Here it is, Goldmine Vintage. Thank you.
Here we go again. I just noticed the prices, dude. $40, $40, $40, $40, $40. Bro, all these jeans are like $40. How much for this prawn? Be ready. Say I won't buy 7 of these and make a needle 7 cut right now. They got vinyl too. I'm gonna try on this Dickies flannel. These like gray Levi's. And then a pair of, I think these are orange label. Let me try. Yeah, orange label 517s. Wait a damn minute. These are fire, what? Giving off a Kiko vibe right now, some Irene trouser vibes, you feel me fam? Sitting on the Kikos, this shit looks real proper. Holy shit. Holy fuck. This is tough. This automatic bop. It's a bop. Alright, I don't know if I fuck with this flannel print. And it's way too small, so maybe the baby bro can bop. But these jeans are what I have a mixed feeling about. So, if you can see, they have a really nice flare, the way they sit. But, look at how big the waist is. Hold on. Look at that. But can you even tell? I'm gonna bop in them both, bro. That flare is sick. 517. Obviously, these aren't the shoes that I'd wear with them, but like, if I wear like my combat boots or something, again, they're really loose. Then I could pull them up too, though. The flannel is a no. The jeans, sheesh. Look at them. Let's bop them.
I was shitting on the place before I even looked through it. That place had just crazy deals. Just goes to show, don't judge a book by its cover. Right now, we're going to Tenpenny, and they're mostly like women's, but we'll see. Thank you.
We got the denim. Vinyl. Is that tapes? 7-Up thing. Jack, you should look at this tote bag. You should look at this tote bag. I don't know any of these. the things. Pocket tee. I don't know if I like this gray though. USA, $10 though. Might try it on. It's a gray Russell. Let's see. I'm gonna try it on.
What the fuck? Independent.
Oh, another blank. How much is this one? $24. About to start my own vintage shop. Got y'all guys on the Russell's proxy. Kind of a neat hat. Mitsubishi Motors. I see no lies. I think it'll fit. Dog, 20 bones? Say less. Literally a perfect fit. This is a go. Oh my god, I'm in love with this. Yeah. This one looks small. We'll see if it fits. Looks kind of cropped in the body. Fits good in the body. It's very loose, cropped. The sleeves are a little short though. I don't know. I think I can make it work. The shoulder's already dropped. Color's pretty good. Yeah, look. My arms aren't gonna get any longer, so this is a go. Discus Athletic. 80s, gray, nice color. Oh yeah, this like gray crew neck right here. This is fire. Sleeves are good, everything. No, the color scheme is really nice. Just to let out some of that steam. For 45 bones, I don't know, it's like an extra large, right?
Yeah.
Super oversized. If you cinch the waist, it kind of works.
The waist is cinched.
Yeah, no, I'm saying like this, it kind of works. And try this on. It looks like I'm gonna rip this shirt. I look yoked though. Yeah, this is a no. I have a feeling this isn't gonna fit either.
Don't forget, you know, you don't have a hat, you know what I'm saying?
Steals, bro. I spent
probably less than $175, and I bought 7 things now. I'm super geeked about all of the crew necks and hoodies, and then also that gray pair of Levi's. Jesus Christ, those are fucking flames.
Back at the hotel, the game's starting. Let's go.
Local IPA. Love me an IPA.
This game is crazy important, bro. That's some bullshit.
Watching the game, probably not gonna be able to watch past the first half, but just recharging. I'm probably gonna change into like a new fit or something. And then we have dinner reservations. We're eating Chinese tonight. That's at 9 o'clock, so.
Tied it up, changed out Russell, Arc'teryx. I'm not wearing these Morels out. I'm gonna wear the Kikos again, but it drops to like 70s, could use a thin hoodie, you know?
I wanted to keep watching the game, but I guess we're just gonna watch on my phone at the restaurant. Fuck it. I'm looking at the cocktails. Look at these names. Big Pimpin', Low Hanging Fruit. You won't tell, I won't tell.
It's a low hanging fruit. Apple martini?
I didn't want to say this out there, but there isn't a single Asian person in the kitchen. And secondly, the table near us, they had crab rangoon on their table. My neck is, it's like hanging, you know, it's almost completely severed, broken. We'll see their take on my culture's food, if you will.
So this is the chilled tofu with cucumbers and cilantro. Looks a little gimmicky. They really rocked me with this like Chinese takeout box with jasmine white rice. Like they couldn't put it in a bowl.
We got the jasmine white rice.
It's so tofu though.
I mean, presentation, right?
Okay.
This actually looks kind of proper.
It looks official. It's kind of sweet and it's like really spicy, but I don't taste the chicken.
These are the lamb cumin buns.
I mean, it looks good. Do you want to take a picture of this?
It looks decent. It comes down to how they marinated the lamb.
This one's actually good.
The spare ribs just touched down. They look decent. They look like how they're supposed to.
Let's go. Tastes like tofu. Chinese barbecue pork.
Alright, so that was Hop Alley. To any Chinese viewers, they'd probably think like, wow, Jin, like you're just wasting money eating like some mid-ass Chinese food, which there is some truth to that, but I really wanted to go to this restaurant because there aren't many Chinese restaurants here in Denver. If you look back in the history of Denver, back in the late 1800s, in the 1880s about, there was like a bloody riot that basically drove all the Chinese people out. There was one individual that was hung. The Chinese population just moved out. Denver Chinatown, that got extinguished, basically. There's just like a lot of like anti-Asian, anti-Chinese sentiment back then. So I really wanted to try the Chinese food out here. And it makes sense, the prices they charge. The prices weren't unreasonable. They were a little pricey, but again, econ major here, supply and demand. There aren't a lot of Chinese restaurants. People that want Chinese food have to go here. I think they did their best in trying to
capture those flavors. It wasn't terrible. It wasn't bad, I'd say. It wasn't amazing, but I thought it was just acceptable. It was definitely acceptable for what it was, for what it's worth. So yeah, man, just wanted to just check that out and like see what was going on. Like, there's like no Chinese population out here, really. I didn't even show you guys this lounge area. It's pretty sick.
Good morning. We are going to the coffee shop and then to the Botanic Gardens. Gonna try and hit those three shops today as well.
Here's the fit. Here we are, Hudson Hill. This area we're in, it's Capitol Hill. It's kind of rough. Kind of rough out here.
Hi.
We got the dalgona, kombucha, turmeric latte, matcha latte. Sounds fire. Toasted baguette.
Oh, that's a piece of ham right there. Ham and egg croissant.
I think the jam one is gonna look better.
Doing the almond croissant again.
Almond croissant.
Yesterday's was better.
Dalgona, I don't wanna mix it yet. It's kind of fucked. It's not mixing well. The blue jam, French butter, and then the baguette.
I think, that's why we went to, that sushi spot in Portland.
Such a bougie ass breakfast. Dalgona, ham and cheese croissant, baguette with blueberry jam and French butter. I don't know what it's been, why it's been like this lately, but I've just been blowing up the bathroom after coffee and like it's fucked. This is what you gotta do, and you gotta put like a flat sheet of toilet paper to prevent any splashing, any pushback.
Yes, sir. The Salvador Dali exhibit. He snapped. These are fire. What? Look up close. He snapped for sure.
Is that real?
Yeah.
It has to be real,
dude.
Oh my god.
Dude. Oh shit, those are real.
It's been this year.
Say hello to that.
Show them that
information. Dude, it looks like it's made out of plastic.
Dude, they're too toxic to touch. Jesus. Look at this guy. The eyes are like black.
I don't know if I want to go upstairs though. They're nowhere to be found.
Garden's kind of vibey.
I think we're gonna hit the Japanese garden. This is vibey. Y'all vibey, y'all. Proper. He's real though, that's the question. Yo. Move out of the way. Gonna check out the hotel gym. Not gonna work out or anything, just gonna peep it real quick. And then we're gonna go do some vintage shopping again. Chest day, maybe not. For sure back day. We can do lat pull downs, rows, got some legs over there, medicine balls, cups are individually wrapped. You can toggle through the settings. And then dispense some water. Very cool. Gonna be back tonight. I'll take you guys through a proper workout. Be an effective, simple vacation workout. Change the foot. We're going to Darklands. Gonna get a coffee there. They have a cafe. And then our reservation at 4:30 for some sushi. Back at the source where we came for dinner at Sapporo. Now everything's open because it's daytime. Darklands Vintage and Cafe. I might stop by Tamaki Den and grab a couple hand rolls too. Right. They go hand in hand pretty much. Try these, put this pair on. 65? What are these though? It's like a 31 weight. Oh, these are Carhartt double knees. What are you looking at there? Some black Levi's. What are those? 50 what? Turn them? 550s? This pair's got like some pretty cool bleach stains. $52. Turn it.
Put the back.
Orange label. I don't know what that says, but orange label, thick bleach stains.
It's a 205, I think. It's pretty cool. Nice bar. $55?
It's a 30 though, I don't think I'd fit it. I like the wash, I don't like this repair right here.
These are 501s.
Maybe I'd go with this pair actually.
55. I don't know where the patch is.
This is really wide though.
This is a nice pair right here. Holy, those are some nice shades. You know what I mean? Maybe like a nice pine green or something. This one right here. This one looks nice.
This is the stuff I plan on trying on so far. We're still adding. I don't like this collar, but the, I don't know. I don't like this end right here.
I feel like this will fit me though.
It's a little long on the sleeves.
A little long, right?
Yeah.
On the sleeves. My arm ends right here.
$35 for this LL Bean with this, I guess someone had their name embroidered.
Very sturdy.
Huh?
paper's blank, but it looks a little too small.
I love Hong Kong.
Meteor.
Oh, it's the same graphic on both sides. Come up to cool. It's a nice ringer tee, $24. It's very clean too, nothing on the back. Let's dive into the colors I would never wear. The navy. Yeah, go try it on. Oh, this is a nice, it's huge though. $22, a single pocket.
These boots right here are sick. DS? How much are these?
$150, wow.
These things are sick.
Anyone know anything about Mason shoes? Blanks. Here's a Russell, $34. This is a Champion. Alpha, Omega, I think this is Roll.
This little zip up.
We're skipping these colors, but I wouldn't wear them. I'm not a big fan of navy either. There's a Champion hoodie. There's like a black, it's really narrow fitting. Some paint distressing. This one's interesting. It's a Russell, but then it has like a turtleneck almost. This one's kind of cool, Jean. Murphy Track and Field. This one's just a black, like a satin finish. Dodge Boys have more fun. This is like the car Dodge. This one's really cool. Ivan in the chain stitch, chain link font. Southeastern Tuck. The colors are nice. The gray and navy, it's a hit. I thought this one was kind of cool. Roger. USMC. This one's okay. I already grabbed like a blank one to try on. So like the Capital denim. Alright, so me and Lil Bro both in here right now. Situation. It's like a little cute little fitting room. Nice lamp, chair. And then here's everything we got hung up. I think this is a really nice orange for one pocket tee. $19. He thinks he needs to tailor them. Honestly, I like them a little long because they have that flare. They'll sit really nice. With this little green crew neck sweatshirt, it looks pretty decent. I mean, maybe you can hem them a little bit, but I think you can work with that. So this is that blank that I picked up off the rack. I'm gonna try it on. It looks like on the back, just blank. I like it a lot. I like the two chest pockets.
Oh yeah. It's a little oversized, but like the arms fit great. The arms fit really good. It's good. I like it. 49. I don't know. It's pretty decent. This grinder man. I don't know what that is. Is that a monkey? This is brown. I don't know if the light's picking up. It looks like it's gonna be a really good fit. Anything else on the back? I'm gonna throw it on real quick. Grinder man.
I like the wide neck because then the chains can show a little bit. I can throw this on top, throw them fits together real quick. Grinder man graphic right there, motif. Yeah, that already looks pretty chill. Another black single pocket. I'm gonna try this on too.
And this tee's, I mean, it's loose, but it feels like narrow, or like kind of long. Like look how long this is. You know, like I'm right here and this goes all the way down here. I don't know about that. Doesn't fit like my other one. All right, I'm gonna try on these. Let's see. These double knees fit. I don't know if I would do that fat cuff right there. Let me uncuff these Johns.
They just look hella wide though.
They need to be like brought in a little bit. They're super wide and long, but they fit fine on the waist. I don't know. I don't know about these. Here's how they look when I pull them all the way up and with shoes. I don't know. They're a little too baggy. These Levi's, they fit really nice. Color though, huh? I mean, these would look good with my Wheaties. Nice little like stressing. This is an orange tee. Yeah, it's decent. Yo, I think I have to pick up these jeans because I've never put on a pair of jeans that fit this perfect on the waist, on the leg. The length is good. And then I'm just gonna scoop them. They're just too perfect. They fit so comfortably too. Button fly. Okay. Here's another Russell. It fits good, but it fits a little tight. Russell, the Muji T, and then the Levi's. So these jeans 55, that's a cop. 26, that's, I think I'll cop it.
Darkland Vintage. That was probably my favorite vintage shop here. So well curated. The vibes were immaculate. Coffee plus vintage, two of my favorite things. I was just chopping it up with the, I don't know if he's the owner, but really, really chill dude. So yeah, if you ever come to Denver, you gotta check out Darkland.
The LL Bean tote, holding all the vintage Johns. Here we go. So I reserved at 4:30 because their happy hour's at 4. Two pieces of nigiri for like $5. Can't beat it.
What?
Can we do two orders of the sake, the bincho, the kompachi? I don't know how to pronounce that one.
Is this all happy hour?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, and then one order is two pieces, so you want 4 pieces total?
Yeah, exactly. Okay. Basically for the first 5, two orders, and then for the last 2, just one order of each.
Sake, bincho, kompachi, both
of them. Actually, for the last 3, the masu, the wagyu tartar, and then the foie gras, those one order. And then for the tastings, can we do the hama chili, the yokai berry, the fish toast.
And then the fish toast is 2 pieces. Should I do 2 of them for 4 pieces?
Sure, yeah. Okay. The pork belly, how many pieces is that?
Probably 4 to 6 bites.
Oh, okay, that's fine. The tamaki, can we try the negi hama?
Uh-huh. And those are 2 piece hand rolls.
Okay, so can we do 2 of those?
Okay, 2 negi hama?
Yeah. And then are all of the drinks alcoholic?
Yeah, I mean we have ramen and sodas, like bottled sodas, and then we can make mocktails too.
Okay, but these ones are all alcoholic.
Yes.
Okay. So then, an ume punch, and
the ume punch is for you or for her.
And then I'll do. You have anything you recommend off the?
Can I actually check your ID real quick?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's all good.
That's fine.
But off the happy hour, I mean, what do you usually like to drink?
I'm open to anything. I can drink sake, I can drink.
Okay, cool. If you're looking for a sake, the Hoyo is great. It's like a slightly dry, served in a masu box. It's cold sake. And then we also have like Sapporo if you want to look for like a lager option.
Okay, I'll try the Hoyo.
The Hoyo?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm dead because like he wouldn't share his recommendations for beverages until he carded me, which is just like this man really did not trust me at all. Really cool beaker to this. All right, right here I have the cold sake. I just had an employee explain to me why this is overflowing. It's for the gratitude that I'm here. Yada yada yada. So basically you can drink from the cup and then the remainder that's in this box you pour back into the cup, or you can drink it out of the box. I'm not drinking out of this wooden box. That is hella unsanitary. So yeah, kanpai. Oh wait, cheers, cheers. This is a ume punch. Try this. Presentation on point. Oh, yeah, mint. Really, really refreshing. This is a ginkgo leaf. This is the kanji for jia, which is home. Ginkgo leaf, it's the same as this right here. Here's the pork belly. This is like 4 bites. It's really small.
Okay, I'm gonna try to get an all-encompassing bite. This is like asparagus, this is strawberry. And then yeah.
flavors are subtle, but they just, when you put them all together, Jesus.
This is literally like chicharron. So good though. Yellowtail with the ponzu, citrus ponzu. Proper, real proper. Look at this.
The black pepper to finish. Oh shit. I just noticed this.
We have a slice of like mandarin. That's where the citrus is coming from. Black pepper and some salt in the ponzu. Mmm. Very, very refreshing. The hotel just melts in my mouth, you know? Here's the fish toast. Had to get two orders. Yard, double up. They killed the tempura batter, look at that. Got the Atlantic salmon, the sake, and then we got some albacore. Proper, yo. Fish toast. This is a spicy aioli or something. I'm gonna do a healthy dip. Mmm, the tempura batter, that fish, like actual fish, not no bullshit. I'm with family, so I'm double dipping. Nigiri on a happy hour menu, it's over. I'm gonna run them to the ground. All right, albacore. Albacore, oh yeah. They must have hand torched it, and then that salt and that, whatever they're garnishing it with, so good.
Mans didn't even finish this drink and he already ordered a second one because it's happy hour, you know, we're a little on the time crunch. So we're gonna finish this. This is a summer breeze. So champagne and I don't know what else I put in this. Who cares? Oh, this one's I think is even better than the ume punch. Very refreshing. Look at the bubblies.
That bubbly.
The Wagyu tartare with egg yolk. Bro, we eating good tonight, yeah? Everybody gotta flick this up because you know, camera eat first. So tank roll style, Wagyu tartare. I think these are like flaky salt, egg yolk, and then like baby chives. Wagyu tartare. Itadakimasu. I'm so happy right now. I love beef tartare, but it's so hard because with low quality beef, and if it's not ordered frequently enough at a restaurant, I can't trust it. This, insane. Negihama yellowtail roll. Yerdi. Salmon with Asian pear and fried kale. Look at this.
Don't forget the veg. Never.
Let's get that Asian pear. Here you go. Here's that Asian pear. Don't forget. And then that salmon.
Mmm. How cool. Shit, there's blueberries too.
Very light, very refreshing. All right, I'm giving you guys a second opinion. Go. Put that blueberry, yep. What
very,
is it?
It's very fresh.
Very refreshing.
With smoked soy and candied garlic.
Thank you. Kompachi just touched down. Let's go, Kompachi. Very good, but not my favorite. Eggplant, lemon miso, finished with sesame seeds. And then the Walu Walu just touched down. Bruh, don't play with me. Okay, one more round. Up close. So another Walu Walu. This one is a gochujang base. Here's a lemon, charred lemon. Walu Walu is like a cousin of tuna. So very flaky and delicious. This is fried in tempura.
Looks like they killed the tempura here again.
Peep the situation right now.
Eggplant,
lemon miso, sesame seeds.
The char on the eggplants is incredible.
Walu walu.
Gochujang dip.
Whoa, the fish is really juicy, really succulent.
I'm getting inspired right now, you know, I've got like dishes brewing away. I'll get back to Chicago. Crazy.
So this one's also walu walu. They gave us spoons to break it up.
There's like some sort of like honey.
Thanks so far, guys.
Very good.
I'm running out of adjectives to describe how good this food is, you know? Like, I'm not even trying to cap right now.
This is anchovy nigiri, just touched down.
I like that a lot. It has this like sourness to it almost.
Crispy rice with charred broccoli, cilantro, onion, and then this sauce. I don't know what they do. This looks crazy. It looks insane.
So I believe at this point all we're waiting for is the foie gras, unless you have received that already and I didn't see it.
I don't think so.
No? Yeah. Okay, cool. Awesome. It's the best bite to end off on anyways.
Like the phan nong, which is like crispiest rice at the bottom of a clay pot rice. The charred broccoli. Broccoli is one of my favorite vegetables. So fire.
Sheesh.
The foie gras.
Thank you.
See, that's the drink I saw earlier.
Oh my god, we eating good. The fuck is you talking about?
Look up close. She's so rich.
Thank you. Some of these are repeats because we had to run it back. Foie gras, quinoa, shiso leaves.
Whoa. The duck. This is one of my favorite ones. There's gotta be one. These two.
The foie gras, the wagyu.
Heavy, heavy hitters. That one never gets old. I could eat that over and over every day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. It's a cloudy, chilled sake. Oh, this one's strong. This one's strong, but it's really, really smooth at the same time. $4. So cheap, bro. This one's a repeat as well. Don't ask why, because you already see what's going on right now. Sheesh. Can you believe this was 5 bone skis? Are you kidding me right now? 5 bone skis? You go and find me this for 5 bone skis.
Let me rap to you guys right now.
Going all the way to the bottom. Check ready if you guys are ready to go, right?
Yeah, you can just leave it. Yeah,
I'm ready. Maybe I don't have it. Oh, here we go.
Thank you.
Of course.
So we got everything in this one bite.
A bite.
Give it to us.
All right.
Sheesh. There's varying textures, right? There's a lot going on in that one bite.
It's a bit cold.
It's really cold too, yeah.
A lot of texture, some sweetness, some crunchiness, some gelatinous, the pineapple, like.
So that green is cilantro ganata, and then the brown crunchy pieces are like the granola, but they call it honey crumble. Shoo!
One tap roulette for the bill. No one's looked at the bill yet. We'll put it underneath. So this is me, this is Jack, this is the OG. I want to pick one. What are you doing?
You're doing, you're doing, you're doing.
Jack's got to put the camera on him.
That's our guy.
That's our guy. Our lucky winner for the night.
We have a loser. Would you like to try again? Damn right we have a loser. No thanks.
Here's the grand reveal. No one's looked at the tab yet.
Nobody's looked at it yet.
The suspense. Uh-oh, it's on the left side. Uh-oh. You can see a lot of damage has been done. This is like when you reveal your cards for blackjack. It goes slow. Uh-oh.
There's more?
There's more. Oh, shit. There we go, Jack.
That was Uchi Denver. There's one in Miami, one in Houston. Really great dining experience. Service was great, ambience was great, food was great. What else is there to say, you know? We're gonna go to this place called Garage Sale. It was a vintage shop recommended to me by the worker at Darklands. Let's just see what's going on. Walk off some of this food. Denim, vinyl, t-shirts, cocktails, 70s. I haven't checked upstairs yet. This place is turning into a bar now. Other place serve coffee with their vintage. This place serves cocktail. I just noticed they're using Pokemon cards to mark their prices. Cool graphic, but we don't do V-necks. You guys know I bike, so I'm gonna try on this shirt. It's a Bianchi tee. I really like the graphic. And yeah, beefy, Hanes beefy, extra large, pre-shrunk.
Playing some good music.
We're playing some good music here, some hits. Yerb. So it says it's a 4648. It's pretty long. I mean, it works with what I'm wearing right now, kind of. What I could do is also get it tailored and just have it brought up to like maybe right here, maybe something like that. It's a little long. Again, waist ends here, it goes down here. It's pretty long. I probably want it right here. I'm gonna take it back and get a hemmed. I think if it were this length, it'd be much better. Be like super boxy, you know? Black tie dinner ride. Third annual. One on the back as well. There's another LL Bean. It's on 50.
Oh my god, it's hot.
This is vibey.
Isn't this like similar to the Cuban flag?
What?
Yeah. Isn't that similar to the Cuban flag?
Pizza for Johnny.
Jesus Christ, this is 24 inches. We almost bought two. Oh my God. Just for your perspective, like this is my hand right here. Hold on, let me open this thing. Oh my goodness, this is disgusting how big it is. Look at this.
Dude,
one slice is bigger than my whole hand.
This is like half my arm. Oh my God.
From my elbow to the hand, and it's literally...
It's 8 o'clock right now.
Jesus, man. Oh my God.
It doesn't mean
this is like a slice of bocce's right now.
Who cares?
This thing is bigger than my whole face. Look at this. We're still going to the gym after this.
You wanted this since we were freshmen.
Dude, that was 4 years ago. All right, we're about to be like...
adults now. In 2 weeks, none of this is even gonna matter.
What the heck are you talking about?
This wasn't a shitty movie.
Realized that all this stuff
like
is all made up. Like, my brother's fraternity also thinks they invented beer pong.
I resonate with Dave Franco. Because that fraternity shit is so dead now.
I take this the wrong way, but I think you're freaking...
Folded up my pickups. This LL Bean tote is actually sick. The color is sick. Here's Jack's pickups.
We really smashing this workout at 11 p.m. I'm feeling lethargic as fuck. I do not want to do this, but I think I'll feel better after working out. And then a nice shower.
Alright, we're gonna do a circuit. We're gonna do rows, we're gonna do... These bad boys. These are Wolverines. And we're gonna do some 21s, you know? Alright, let's get started. Back pull down.
Don't think you play, nigga, I ain't playing, nigga. Thought I'd be mean and love you. Well, I shoot a nigga probably. Bitch, I'm a top shot tough. Buy my what? Talk for what? Shoot send shots. Shoot bend blocks. Don't think I'm playing, nigga, I ain't playing. When I'm telling me mean and love you. Fishbowl, send shots, bend blocks. Send them back. All of my niggas be into that. Get the clapping niggas, get the slapping niggas, get the clipping niggas, get the switching niggas. Expect your niggas slapping 11. I cannot work no 95, cause I'm trapping 24 traffic. I gotta get to the cash, I gotta get to the breach. Send a nigga up to heaven, preach. And I smoke that grade A. Shoot a nigga J.A. Don't think I'm playing, nigga, I ain't playing.
Gotta do at least 3 sets of this circuit, but I'll spare you guys. You don't need to see me doing every set. I already feel better, getting a little pump going. And then for core, we're gonna do suitcases. Oh shit, they have plates too. Probably do some of these.
Bitch, I'm a top shot tough. Buy mine what? Talk for what? Shoot send shots. Shoot bend blocks. Don't think I'm playing, nigga, I ain't playing. But I'm telling me me in the lobby.
Can't believe I forgot this, but that pull downs, you gotta couple it with this. Just finished the circuit. I'm gonna do a little bit of extra credit. What I call extra credit. Just because that was pretty quick. Pretty intense. I need to stop sleeping on doing core. I'm gonna do these like cross body. There's one more back movement that I want to do. I don't even know if it's considered extra credit. It might have just been homework that was left out. You feel me? Bring that down. And then. This thing's so heavy. What the fuck? Weights fluctuate from gym to gym, so. I'm just gonna do 10s.
Oh, many man wish that fun. Find them in the island. Dread head niggas in the.
Lobby,
we go skish skish, Ricky Bobby. Tell me mean a lobby. Well, I shoot a nigga blind. Bitch, I'm a top shot top.
Top shot top.
Buy my what? Talk for what?
Talk for
yeah.
What?
Shoot, say, shot. Shoot, bend blocks. Don't think I'm playing, nigga. I ain't playing. What? I'm telling me mean a lobby.
Frank White. I'm gonna be back tomorrow morning. Tomorrow's the last full day. We're checking out. Gonna probably hit a shoulder workout just because it's time to clean it up. You know, I gotta get back to the routine. And I stay fit. I mean, we've been doing so much walking. I'm not afraid that I haven't been overeating. So I don't think I gained much weight, if any. If any, I probably even lost weight. But the alcohol and then like lack of exercise, like proper exercise, not just walking. I got small veins, so I don't even know if you can see this shit. Can you? Maybe these a little bit. Small veins.
Fuck you.
is what made me feel like shit.
Doing a coffee mask, drinking some H2O. See you guys tomorrow. I like my yummy yellow. In the ash feel like jello. Shorty like skinny tatties. Ash fresh, so I grabbed it. I gave it a stick and I lashed it. No rubber, no plastic. You know how to get right, mama. I gotta get my baby.